Hi, this is Babita Jaishankar, and today I want to talk to you about this wonderful weave from Orissa. It's called a Santal cotton sari, and it's a tribal weave. And it has got this amazing texture. It's a cotton sari. The cotton quality is a low quality cotton, but it's a thicker cotton. And it's woven with, again, the thicker cotton. So it has this character to it. Also the weave, what is done, the motifs, you can actually feel it because again the cotton being thick and it feels like an embossed motifs. So these are the colors. It has, again, the texture, the character, the feel, the drape is amazing. The thing that it comes with is a very low width, because that's how it is. The looms are very so it is not a 44 width sari. It comes as a 40 width sari. So the width is quite less than the usual sari width. So I also like it because of that. I wear it like with my kolhapuri. The anklets are seen, and I wear it like ankle length sari. If you want a little more higher, absolutely fine. It looks absolutely wonderful. The texture is quite thick, so you'll have to, you don't have to necessarily wear a skirt, underskirt it, inside it, because again, it's not a see-through sari. It also doesn't stick to your body, so it's absolutely fine if you don't want to wear an underskirt. So I'm not wearing an underskirt here. So what I have done is I tie the sari on the side, on my right-hand side. And then I am taking one round around, and then the extra comes as pleats. I have taken only a couple of pleats, because the sari being quite thick, I have taken only three pleats here and one extra round inside. Then absolutely it won't be, you don't have to worry about the see-through, if the sari gets see-through or, so you get an extra layer inside. So here, while wearing the sari, keep your legs little apart, because since there is no skirt, you also want that freedom of movement. So keep your legs little apart, and then you tie, and it's absolutely, the knot is quite secure, because again, the cotton being a thicker cotton, it is absolutely secure there. So you don't have to worry about it. And then after I have tucked in the pleat, I have also kept this part quite neat, because I didn't want any fabric there. Again, the focus being the palla here. So I just kept it absolutely neat here. And I have taken the palla to the front and given it a tug or a twist inside, because the extra tassels and things, I didn't want, again, nothing to be distracting the whole beauty of the palla. So I have taken it, and then I have given it a knot here. So if you can see a knot, you can try this without the blouse too, if you are a little more creative about how to pin the palla. So here you can actually pin it up, and this is how neat it will be. So you don't have to necessarily maybe wear even a blouse. So you do try that and let me know how it works out for you. And here the palla is absolutely gorgeous, and I really, really wanted to put the palla in focus. So here it is, my Santal cotton, my way. Hope you like this drape, and give it a try and let me know what modifications did you do according to your likes. Take care. Bye.